Wearable technology is quietly revolutionising physical performance, and one company at the forefront of it is Whoop. They invited us out to their HQ in Boston to see what it was all about, and that video is up on GCN now. I hadn't heard of them until a few months ago, but colleague Jeremy Powers has been working with a Whoop band for a long time. And so when they asked us to make a video, we thought, well, yeah, you might be interested to know about it too. So what is it exactly? Well, this is a Whoop strap. In it are five different sensors that measure an array of data and also a battery that lasts 5 days. You pair it up to an app, and then together they unlock a whole load of insights into your physiology, including how recovered you are, your cardiovascular strain for that day, how much training load you should take on at any given moment, and also your sleep quality. Now, those sensors will monitor your heart rate variability, the ambient temperature, your movement, and also your skin conductivity. And in total, it will generate up to 100 megabytes of data per day. And you can also, if you wish, pair it up to a third-party device to add heart rate functionality to it. So, for example, like your Wahoo device. I will start with heart rate and heart rate variability. So you see these green lights underneath there. So they shine directly into your skin, and they tell you how much blood is pumping beneath the surface. Because as your heart beats, the volume of blood momentarily increases and that absorbs more light. And then in the gaps between your heartbeats, there is less blood flowing and then more light is therefore reflected back to the Whoop strap. And through that, it can then tell you what your pulse is. And also by timing the gaps between heartbeats, it can of course tell you what your heart rate variability is. Now, I'll admit, I thought that heart rate was quite a constant thing. But no, and not only is it not constant, actually the variability between heartbeats can be an indication of your recovery status. When I say can, what Whoop say they do differently to other wearables, and they do indeed have a patent on it, is to measure your heart rate variability and your resting heart rate at a specific point during your sleep cycle each and every day. And what that does is it generates consistent and comparable data as opposed to being prone to errors, like for example, if you try and measure your resting heart rate after you've just woken up. Those values that it generates are unique to you. And so in order to work out your baseline, when you first put it on, Whoop will take a few days to get to know you. Then once it's got an idea of your own unique parameters, it can then start to generate things like your recovery status. So it works that out from your resting heart rate, which is much as we always thought, actually, in that high resting heart rate is a sign that you're fatigued or perhaps coming down with an illness, whereas a low resting heart rate is a good sign that you are recovered. In contrast, though, heart rate variability is the opposite. So a low heart rate variability is a sign that you are fatigued or perhaps coming down with an illness and could do with a day off or at least an easy day, whereas high heart rate variability suggests that you are ready to go and take on some serious training load. Then the final piece of the recovery puzzle is your sleep, both duration and quality. And we'll get onto that in a moment. All the data is displayed in the app, both for a given day and then laid out over time so you can observe trends. There is a desktop version as well that gives greater visibility over longer periods of time. Now, when you open up the app, that is your landing screen. So you can see on there a snapshot of the data it's recorded for today. You've got my recovery status, yellow, unfortunately, this morning. Just below that, you've got my sleep. Then above it, you've got strain scores. Firstly, for my commute this morning that is auto-detected. And then above that, the strain score for the day. Now, if I swipe right, then you get a bit more detail about that. Because you're wearing a heart rate monitor effectively for 24 hours a day, Whoop is able to calculate how much cardiovascular strain you have undertaken in that given day. And it ranks it on a score of 0 to 21. Before you go, wow, that's an impressive figure. Do bear in mind that that is unique to me. And so perhaps if you had joined me on my commute this morning and for the rest of my day, yours might be a little bit different. If we press on that, we get a little snapshot of what I've been up to. So max heart rate, average heart rate for the day, and also estimated calorific expenditure. Now, if I click on that bit there, then we get to see the activity. As I said, it was auto-detected earlier on. That too is given a strain score on the same scale, 0 to 21 as previously. And there you go, again, we've got a snapshot of my average heart rate and my max heart rate, calories, and so forth. If I scroll down, you then get to see 7 days of strain score plotted on a graph. And you can see on mine, it's pretty polarized between the days when I ride and the days when I don't. I put that down to the fact that when I ride, I tend to ride as hard as I possibly can. If we then swipe left, you can see a graph where strain score is plotted against my recovery status. And this is super interesting, because actually I don't think there's all that much correlation between the two for me. And I attribute that to factors other than my cycling perhaps being more significant to my recovery status than exercise. And I think that's one of the strengths of using heart rate variability in this instance. And that is that it's affected by factors other than just exercise. So things like stress and diet and sleep and alcohol and hydration status. And so you could, over time, work out what it is that's mainly influencing your recovery status with an aim to try and improve it. Because don't forget, if you're trying to get as fit as you possibly can, you need to train as hard as you possibly can, but that is limited by your ability to recover. So improve that, and potentially you unlock a little bit extra. Then we have the sleep page. Now, because you're wearing your Whoop 24/7, it records whilst you are sleeping. From that, it can therefore work out what time you went to bed, what time you went to sleep, and the quality of your sleep as well. So how many disturbances you got, and indeed the types of sleep that you were getting as well. If you then scroll over, every morning you can answer a really short little questionnaire that basically gets indications of how you prepared for sleep. So whether or not you had any caffeine before bed or alcohol, or whether you were working before bed, anything that might affect your sleep quality. Now, you can see that it gives you a percentage score for your sleep performance. And that's based on the amount of sleep that you got versus the amount of sleep that Whoop calculates that you needed. And if you scroll down, as with the other pages, you can see that that's then plotted over the previous 7 days. Now, a really cool little extra bit is the sleep coach. And this is where you can use Whoop to help you actually get more sleep. And so you can see at the top, I want to, I've gone for get by, fairly lowly ambition at the moment, but you can tailor that to perform or indeed peak. And you'll see that it therefore tells you how much longer you need to spend in bed, hopefully asleep, and it tailors the time that you should go to bed and the time that you need to wake up. The last point to mention is one of Whoop's latest developments, which is called the Strain Coach. And basically, this will give you recommendations for your training at any point in any day based on your recovery status and also your current strain score. And it will gauge what level of workout you need for optimal training. When you start an activity, you will then see in real time how much work you have to do in order to reach that optimal strain score, and indeed, when you are doing too much. There is a bit of a degree of manual adjustment that you can do. What constitutes optimal is fairly broad, which is good for people like me who like to tend to smash it every time they go out. If Whoop is something you are interested in, I would definitely recommend heading over to their website. Loads of good info on there. They also have a regular podcast as well, which has some absolutely great stuff on. To get Whoop itself, the band is actually free when you sign up for a membership. So if you sign up for the minimum 6 month membership, it's $30 per month. The longer your initial commitment, the more the cost is reduced, down to $18 per month. If you haven't seen the GCN video yet, I would definitely recommend heading over there now. You can get through to it by clicking on screen. Otherwise, just give this video a big thumbs up.